Today's reading is Exodus 23. Don't spread false rumors. Don't plot with evil people to act as a lying witness. Don't take sides to important people to do wrong. When you act as a witness, don't stretch the truth to favor important people. But don't probe important people in your lawsuits either. When you happen to become upon your enemy's ox or donkey that has wandered off, you should bring it back to them. When you see a donkey that belongs to someone who hates you and is lying down under a load that you are not inclined to set it free, but you must help to set it free. Don't underestimate the justice that your poor deserve in their lawsuits. Stay away from making a false charge. Don't put an innocent person who is right to death, because I will not consider innocent to do such evil. I don't take a bribe, because a bribe blinds the clear-sighted, suburb the cause of those who are right. Don't oppress an immigrant. You know what it's like to be an immigrant, because you were immigrants in the land of Egypt. For six years, you should plant crops on your land and gather its produce. But in the seventh year, you should leave it alone, undisturbed, so that your people may eat. What they leave behind, the wild animals may eat. You should do the same with your vineyard and your olive trees. Do your work in 6 days, but on the seventh day you should rest, so that your ox and donkey may rest, and even the child of your female slave and the immigrant may be refreshed. Be careful to obey everything I said to you. Don't call on the names of other gods. Don't even mention them. You should observe a festival for me 3 times a year. I observe the festival of the unleavened bread. I command you, eat unleavened bread for 7 days at the appointed time of the month of Abib, because it was the month that you came out of Egypt. No one shall appear to me empty-handed. Observe the festival of harvest for the early produce of your crops that you planted in the field, and the gathering festival at the end of the year, when you gather your crop of fruit from the field. All your males should appear 3 times a year before the Lord God. Don't offer the blood of my sacrifice and anything leaven. Don't let the fat of my festival offering to be left over into the morning. Bring the best of your lands, early produce, to your Lord, your God's temple. Don't boil a young goat in its mother's milk. God's promise. I'm about to send a messenger in front of you to guard you on your way and to bring you to the place I made ready. Pay attention to him and do as he said. Don't rebel against him. He won't forgive the things that you do wrong, because I am what I am. I am with him. But if you listen carefully and do what he says and do all that I say, then I'll be an enemy to your enemies and fight those who are fighting you. When my messenger goes in front of you and brings you to the armories of the Hivites, Perizzites, and Canaanites, and the Hivites and the Jebusites, I wipe them out. I don't bow to their gods or worship them, or do what they do. Instead, you should completely destroy them and just smash your sacred stones, pillars to bits. But if you worship the Lord your God, the Lord will bless you with bread and water. I'll take the sickness away from you, and no woman will miscarry or infertile your land. I'll let you live a full, long life. My terrifying refutation will precede you, and I'll throw all the people that you meet into a panic. I'll make your enemies turn your back on you. I'll send insect swarms in front of you to drive out the Hivites, the Canaanites, the Hittites, and before you. I won't drive them out before you in a single year, and the land won't be abandoned, and the wild animals won't multiply around you. I'll drive them out you little by little, but until your numbers grow, you eventually possess the land. I'll set your borders from the Reed Sea and the Philistine Sea, turn river the desert to river. I'll hand the inhabitants to the land over to you, and you will drive them out before you. Don't make any convenience with them or their gods. Don't allow them to live in your land, or they will lead you to to sin against me. If you worship their gods, they'll become a dangerous trap for you.